Hello, everybody, and welcome to Let's Look at Avernum, Escape from the Pit. This is a new indie RPG strategy slash dungeon crawling game just released on Steam, and it really seems like this is the season for dungeon crawlers for whatever reason. I mean, we had Legend of Grimrock, Hack Slash Loot, and now Avernum, Escape from the Pit, but this is actually a game from Spiderweb Software, and they are an indie studio that's been around for like 20 years doing these really old-school kind of strategy slash RPGs. This game kind of most reminds me of like the old school Ultima games that you would play, you know, back in the early 90s, back when that series was still pretty solid. I never really played a lot of those Ultima games, so a lot of this goes over my head, but I can definitely see that if you were into those old school, like particularly PC, kind of hardcore RPGs back in the early 90s, this would definitely be up your alley. So I'm going to load game here. I'm going to start up with Lagrin Must Die, and I will do a little bit of explanation of the basic mechanics of the game before we get too far in. So you can see this game is a dungeon crawler. It looks kind of similar to a game like Diablo, but it's turn-based, not real-time. Sort of. It's kind of a mixture of turn-based and real-time. The exploration is real-time, but the... Well, actually, that's not totally fair. Anyway, first things first. You'll see it as we get into it. I'm going to open up my inventory here. You can see that our first character, our warrior here, is called Fistbro. Then we have our rebel, who is Never Trust a Bro. Our cleric, who is Pray Bro. And our magic lass, who is obviously our sorcerer. So we are going to take our warrior and heal him up a little bit with a healing potion, because he's a little low. Now, the way you do exploration in this game is by just clicking around with the mouse. So we can click here, get people to move around, and there's two phases of the game, the exploration phase and the combat phase, and we'll see the combat phase pretty soon. So one of the hallmarks of this game so far is that it is very, very rich on its story. So you'll just be walking around, and you'll meet people, and there will be huge walls of text that you would be wise to read if you wanted to progress through the game and, of course, get the full experience of actually experiencing the entire story. So it's very dense on story, even though it might be a little graphically crude and definitely does not have maybe the production values that people are used to in this day and age, like no voice acting, no cutscenes, stuff like that. It's all conveyed via text, very similar to an old-school PC RPG. Basically, we were to kind of set up the story in the game before we get into this combat, which is awaiting us as we round this next corner, I promise you. We are under the control of the Empire, and the Empire is like an overarching governmental body that controls this entire world. And we made some kind of slip up, maybe we humiliated a member of the Empire, and he said, "Alright assholes, well, what I'm gonna do for that is toss you down in this big-ass pit." So it's pretty much exactly the same story setup as Legend of Grimrock, where, you know, someone just, this is Sparta's us, into a pit, and we have to find our way out. So we're in this pit, and while we were here, we found this dude by the name of Lagran. And Lagran is like Dennis Leary's character from Demolition Man. He's happy to be down here in this prison because he's away from the, you know, autocratic controls of the Empire. So we're going to have to fight him in order to get our key and actually get the heck out of here. So you can see up here we've got Lagran, his thugs, and a cave wolf. So as we move in here, we'll probably get some dialogue options. Alright, so this is pretty indicative of the kind of screen you're going to see a lot in Avernum Escape from the Pit. Just a huge wall of text. I'm not actually going to read this out for you guys. You can pause the video and read it if you so choose. But if you are indeed playing the game, I would encourage you to read it. Basically, this dude's like, "Oh, holy shit, these guys are actually fairly strong." So we're like, "Hey, you know what, dude, just surrender. If you just surrender, we'll spare your life." And he's like, "No, I'm not going to do that." So instead, we're going to engage in fisticuffs here. Now we are in the combat phase, which is the second phase of the game. So instead of moving our party around all at the same time, we now control them one by one. And if you look at their pictures, you can see how many action points they have. Or action power. I honestly don't know. But action power sounds like a rapper name, so I'm going to go with that. So every time we move, it takes up one of these APs. And when we attack, it ends our turn. So we just moved Fistbro up here, and then we're going to attack Lagrin. Do 23 damage. That's fairly solid. Then we're going to take Never Trust a Bro. Climb up here. We've got some more AP left. So we'll do an attack there. We have our cleric. So we'll come up here, we'll put him like outside of the line of fire a little bit so that he isn't as prone to physical attacks, because obviously he has less vitality. But I do have a ranged weapon on him by way of this crude javelin, so we'll select that, do some damage to him. No, apparently we missed. And then we'll take our sorceress and we'll put her up here and do the same thing. And this time we'll actually cast some magic. So let's cast Bolt of Fire. There you go, 28 damage to Lagrin, that's pretty solid. Now Lagrin did some pretty substantial damage to my Fistbro up there in the front, but luckily his archers are apparently retarded, and his cave wolf is not very strong, so we'll just continue doing some attacking here. Try to get Lagrin down. If you kill the head of the beast, then the rest will just fall apart. So we're doing some pretty solid attacks here. Let's see if our priest has magic. I've never actually used this. Minor heal. Heals some of the damage inflicted on one character. Here's status effects. Smite, and Protection. You know what? Let's use Minor Heal on Fispro. There you go. Heals him for 18, takes him back to full health. And we'll use another different magical spell with our Sorceress. We'll summon a beast to help us out. So we have a Dire Wolf here. Not a Radiant Wolf? I guess, unfortunately. This wolf has been confused, unfortunately. There we go. Hopefully it's going to do some attacks on Lagrin. Perfect. So we'll just continue beating up on this Lagrin asshole here. Soon he will probably be mostly dead. We'll do another ranged attack on him. Not going to worry about the Cave Wolf too much. And why not do another attack here? We'll just do Firebolt again, because I know how that shit works. And Lagrin is at like 50% HP. Alright, so now we get like halfway through the fight. This guy becomes an asshole. A cloud of lavender smoke spreads out, choking you, confusing you. Lagrin turns and runs towards the gate, the key in hand. Okay. So everyone scatters. Our Cave Wolf is apparently not affected, so he might actually still kill this guy. I've never actually summoned a beast to help with the attack before. I didn't control those guys there. They just ran away because of the poison, I guess. Alright, so he goes towards the exit gate. And he actually manages to escape. So once we stop being confused and poisoned, we are going to come back here and try to kill all of Lagrin's followers. Alright, so let's murder this Cave Wolf before we do anything else. There we go. We'll get our Prey Bro to come up here. Do some attacking with his melee weapon this time, because he's super close to the enemy. And I'm not sure if our Sorceress can get all the way up there. No. Okay. So we'll just hope that our Cleric survives. Dire Wolf is doing some pretty solid work here. Managed to kill one of the archers. Apparently I've been slowed. And otherwise, we will just continue attacking here. We have only one more dude to take out. Dire Wolf's going to do a fairly good job at that, actually. This is a good summon. Okay, so now we've killed everything here. We can exit combat mode and re-enter, like, peaceful mode. Now, we probably do need some healing. Let's use some minor heal on ourselves. No, not Direwolf, Prey Bro. There we go. Use some minor heal on ourselves, and I think that's largely good. Now we can scout out the area for items on the ground. You can see there's lots of bars of iron and bags of meal. They weigh a pretty substantial amount, though. So I'm just going to leave those for now, because obviously if we pick up too many of those, we will be encumbered. Let's just continue exploring over here. I guess we got a little bit more combat. We'll take out these huge rats. I can see some decent items on the ground. So we'll murder these rats and then pick that up. And then we'll get into a little bit more of like the hub world that we'll be dealing with. Alright, so we'll just take out these huge rats. I forgot that the Dire Wolf is still with us. That's pretty awesome. I'm not sure how long he's going to stay around for. I think they only last for 6 turns, but... nonetheless, a nice ally to have. So I made a mistake here and put my squishy characters on the front lines, but oh well. Never trust a bro. Gonna deal some critical damage here. Magic glass, similarly. Okay, now we're gonna see what we have on the ground. We got some ham. I'll pick up that ham. We can eat that for health. I'll pick up this flawed crystal, which we can sell in town for money. Otherwise, I will just end my combat here and then continue moving. It looks like our wolf has probably given up on us now. Alright, so what we can do now is follow Lagrin out up top here. And this will actually take us into the hub world, like the first town that we're going to live in. Consider this to be this game's version of like Tristram. Alright, again, I'm not going to read this, but essentially we're a little worried because all these guys here are archers, but then some dude comes out and he's like, hey, don't shoot these guys. They just murdered that asshole in the caves. Alright, and again, we're gonna ask if they caught Lagrin. Apparently they just let him escape. Again, feel free to pause the video if you want to see what Owen Wilson here is saying. I'm just gonna try to get him to finish his dialogue tree. As you can see, there's quite a lot of reading going on here. Alright, so basically what that guy told me was I need to go see a guy called, I forget his name, but I know exactly where he is. There he is. Tor. So we're gonna go see Tor. Tor is going to give us supplies. This other guy gives us the opportunity to work with the mayor. I'm just going to ignore him for now. But again, obviously the experience is enriched. Is that really a word? Is enriched, that's what I'm looking for, by the story. So definitely feel free to, if you're actually playing the game, or if you're into stories like this, check it out. Because it is dense. That would be the word that I would use to describe it. And when I look through like the critical reception of the games that Spiderweb Software had made before in their career... their last big one came out, I think, last September. It was like Avadon the Black Fortress, apparently a game very similar to this. And the criticisms levied against it were like crude graphics, the sound design was not fantastic, but all of the praise that was heaped upon it was because of the dense story, and I would say that definitely holds true here. So we'll talk to Tor, I'm going to get Tor to give me some supplies. And then his dialogue tree will be over in 1 second. Good. So he's basically just giving us a bunch of money and some supplies as well. So if I look through my inventories now, yeah, he's giving me some bread. He's giving me some dried meat. We have a silver necklace, which I guess we can equip, because why not? And then we've just got healing potions on everybody else. So from this point on, basically the world is our oyster. So from here we can explore outwards, if I can remember where the heck to go here. There we go. Yes, now we can exit out into the actual world, and we can choose where we want to go next. And the map actually switches to kind of like an even more overhead style, because we're going to be covering a lot more ground here. So if you see these guys moving around, this is a patrol that we can go talk to, and they'll give us some valuable information if I could actually run into them. They warn us about bandits and goblins. Oh well, I actually want to get into some combat. Now what we could do, and what you would probably do if you were playing this game, you know, not for the purposes of making a video right now, is go enter this town and talk to some people, sell some goods. But that's boring-ass RPG stuff. So I'm going to come up here, and maybe we'll take a look at what's on the ground here. This seems weird. And maybe there's something I can pick up there? No, I must be misreading that. What we're going to look for is some kind of combat that we can get into. So I'll check out the sign. Katra's 3 miles west, okay. This foliage is kind of weirding me out. I don't know what it is, man. All these purple hills. We got another patrol that we'll run into. Be very careful if you're planning to travel further west. Well, I am. Because I don't want to be careful. I want to live on the edge. And hopefully we'll actually run into some monsters here. Okay, Slith Raiders to the west. I think I see some. Now, these guys may actually be too strong for me. I've never fought a Slith. But only a Slith deals in absolutes. So we'll see if we can actually take these guys out. Where are they? Where the heck? Okay, there they are. Oh, they're goblins. Okay, and there's a lot of them. Well, let's just dive into things. We'll send Fistbro over here to do some attacking. Oh, they don't appear that strong. Do the same thing here. Oh, Praybro, not as strong as I would have hoped. But we'll do our patented Bolt of Fire spell. And there's one goblin dead. Drop some crystals for us. Alright, I was hoping they wouldn't do too much damage, and that does indeed appear to be the case. You can see also there's like a combat log down where you would expect like a chat log to be that will tell us what the heck is going on here. So now we are surrounded. Let's start taking these guys out. Start by taking this guy out. This is Never Trust a Bro. Let's use her bow. Try to get this guy. I thought it would kill him. Sadly no, but we do still kill him. And we will summon a beast to help us with our sorcerers here. So far the sorcerer seems to be like an incredibly useful class. And they are really picking on Fist Bro here. But we'll fight back with him. Whoa! That zombie means business. Switch back to our melee weapon. And with Prey Bro, we will use some magic to heal our Fist Bro. Where is it? There we go. So that's going to take him basically back to full. And, you know, why not summon another Bolt of Fire? Maybe take out this goblin? Excellent. So we are absolutely going to win this fight. Attacking here. Zombie's gonna do some damage. Never Trust a Bro's gonna get the killing shot. Let's throw some javelins at this goblin. Yeah, 17 damage, nothing to sneeze at. We can just do some melee damage, I think, with our sorceress now, because all these guys are fairly low on health. Let's murder this goblin, drop some coins. Never thought you could summon a zombie to help you in combat. That definitely, you know, makes things easier for you. If only it converted all of the other enemies to zombies when it hit them, and then they fought on our side as well. That'd be a great game, man, where you play as the zombie, trying to get more zombies to, like, accrue to your side. Alright. So we are still, like, this is only about an hour into the game, maybe even less, like 45 minutes, so I'm still getting tutorials here. There's tutorial help on using blessings, but now we can actually level up, and again, if you played, like, Diablo, you probably recognize this screen right here. So let's increase our strength on... Wow, that picture is freaking me out. Increase our strength on Fist Bro. We have 2 points to spend. Let's upgrade our sword. And can I upgrade this? Hardiness? Sure, why not? And wow, we have some traits as well that we can upgrade. Let's upgrade improved strength. That seems like a good thing to get on a strength type character. Now let's go to our mage, who has also leveled up. Sorry, not our mage, our rebel. We'll level up her dexterity. And why not level up her ability to use bows as well? And why not sharpshooter as well? And improve dexterity. This all seems very simple to me right now. I'm not putting a lot of work into this. This is just basically for the purposes of this video. So on our priest, we'll level up intelligence. Seems smart. We'll level up his hardiness, which gives... Oh, we can't, actually. Now we can, which gives him increased armor. And why not improved intelligence as well? And with our sorceress, let's do something a little bit funky. We'll level up her intelligence again. We will also level up her melee weapons and hardiness. Okay, not too intense right now. And why not level up energy blessing? Increase maximum spell energy by 5%. That seems pretty solid. And I guess I'm pretty much going to call it quits on Avernum Escape from the Pit right there. This is definitely an RPG for you if you're into those, like, early 90s RPGs. I mean, what you see is what you get. I feel like I say that in a lot of videos, but here even more so. This is definitely appealing to a very niche audience, and you know, it's hard for me to say whether this is good or bad. If you're into games with, like, an incredibly dense story, and you don't mind reading that much, this could definitely be up your alley as long as you can get over the, of course, crude graphics. But for people who are just, like, a little bit casual about this, or are more used to modern RPGs, I'm gonna guess that this is probably not gonna be up your alley. But of course, you know, there's only one way to find out. Avernum Escape from the Pit, now available for $8 this week on Steam, but it will be going up to $10 after that first week minus 20% sale happens. So, you know, if you're interested, definitely check it out. There's not a lot of games like this anymore. So if this is your genre of choice, not saying it is my genre of choice, because it 100% is not, but if it is yours, you know, might as well support it. I mean, the studio's been around for a long time, they're good at what they do, and, you know, if you want to keep seeing games like this, you're going to have to support the ones that actually do come out. As always, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.